students, here I'm going to teach you science of class 8, chapter 1, that is crop production and management. Students, we all know that we all are dependent on plants for our survival. And we all know there is a large population present in whole world. And we all are directly or indirectly depend on the plants. So to fulfill our needs of yield, we have to follow some certain kinds of agricultural practices. So now we are going to start our chapter where we are going to read about what are crops, types of crops, uses of crops and how can we manage it for the large population. And animal husbandry, because directly or indirectly animals are involved in the crop production. So let's start our chapter with the first point, that is what are crops. The same kind of plant which are grown by men in a very large area, it's called crop. Okay, for example, if I say I have grown a single plant in a pot, can we call it crop? No, that's not the crop. But if I say I have grown a very huge number of plants in a very large area, can we call it crop? Yes, of course, that's the crop. Now, what we get from the crop? We get some useful products from the crop and of course some nutrition which are useful for our survival. Now, the next topic is what type of plants are involved in crop production. There are three types of plants involved in crop production. First one is cereal giving plants. Second one is vegetable giving plants. And third one is fruit giving plants. Okay, so let's talk about them in detail. First of all, we talk about cereals. Any grass cultivated for the edible components of its grain are called cereals. Means the plant which look like a grass and from which we get some eatable components are called cereals. Like rice, wheat, paddy are called cereals. Next point is vegetables. So it is the any part of the plant that is consumed by human as food is called vegetable. And we all know about some kinds of vegetable and we all know about the examples of vegetables like tomato, potato, onion, carrot, etc. Next point is fruits. So they are seed bearing structure of flowering plants. It's called fruits. So now the examples of fruits are grapes, apple, oranges, guava. These all are the examples of fruits. Now the next point is some basic terminology of this chapter is agriculture. What is agriculture? It is a process of growing crops on large scale. Now, what is next point is horticulture. It is a process of growing fruits and vegetable and ornamental plants. Okay. Now, what is the difference between agriculture and horticulture? Agriculture, where we cultivate only cereals. Horticulture, where we cultivate only vegetable and fruits. Okay. Now the next point is types of crops. There are three types of crops. One is kharif crop, second one is rabi crop, and third one is zaid crops. First, kharif crop. Kharif crop, these crops are sown in beginning of monsoon, that is between June and July. They need much water, that is why we sown them before monsoon. And they are harvested by the month of September or October. The example of kharif crop is corn and rice. The next crop is rabi crop. Rabi crop are sown in winter, that is between November or December. And they are harvested by the month of March and April. The example of rabi crops are wheat and barley. Now the zaid crops, crops are sown in summer because they need extreme heat to grow. Example of zaid crop are watermelon and cucumber. Next point is agricultural implements. So those tools which are used for agriculture or agriculture practices are called agriculture implement. So there are some kind of agriculture implement like plow, hoe, cultivator and seed drill. What is the plow? So plow, it's meant for plowing. What is the plowing? Loosening and turning of soil or mixing of soil is called plowing. So, plough basically made up of wood and it's drawn by a pair of bulls or other animals. What is the use of plough? It is used for tilling, adding fertilizer and removing weeds. Now, the next implement is hoe. It's worked like blade and it's pulled by animals. It is used for removing weeds and for loosening soil. The next implement is cultivator. It's a kind of plough. And when plough is attached to a tractor, it is called as cultivator. Next implement is seed drill. Used for sowing seeds. By this implement, seeds are sown at right depth and it's also save time. So these are the implements. Now, remaining topics we will cover in the next video. Thank you so much.